وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد إن شاء الله تعالى today we're going to start the explanation of the kitab أخلاق حملت القرآن written by الإمام أبي بكر محمد بن الحسين الآجري رحمه الله الإمام الآجري رحمه الله this kitab of his أخلاق حملت القرآن is a kitab, if a person reads it and studies it, will truly realize that it's a blessed book. It's a great book. And it has a lot of benefits in it. As you're going to see, inshallah ta'ala, as the episodes unravel, inshallah ta'ala. This kitab focuses on etiquettes and the akhlaq of the person who's carrying the Qur'an. And this kitab is actually considered to be from the awailul musannafat. From the early works that were written in the akhlaq, the etiquettes and the manners of the carrier of the Qur'an. It's actually considered to be from the first books that were written in this particular field or aspect. And this kitab, the author, rahimahullah, he dictated it. And he dictated it in al-Masjid al-Haram. And he dictated it 6 years before he passed away. When the year was 354. So he dictated it 6 years before he passed away, rahimahullahu ta'ala. As we all know, the Qur'an is a book that has inside it, or it teaches us manners, akhlaq. It teaches us, the Qur'an teaches us it. It's found in the Qur'an. The tarbiyah that we need is found in the Qur'an. ولذلك, the people of the Qur'an are people who withhold these etiquettes, these manners, and they come with it. And they strive within themselves to adorn themselves with these etiquettes and these manners. ولذلك, our mother Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, when she was asked about عن خلق رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, when she was asked about the Prophet's manners, she said, أَلَسْتَ تَقْرَأُ الْقُرْآنَ Do you not read the Qur'an? Do you not read the Qur'an? And she then said, فَإِنَّ خُلُقَ النَّبِيِّ The etiquette of the Prophet ﷺ is كَانَ الْقُرْآنَ That the Prophet ﷺ, his etiquettes and his manners is the Qur'an. And Imam Muslim narrated this in his Sahih. So it is necessary, especially in this month of Ramadan, that we work hard to take in our manners from the Qur'an and our etiquettes and us taking discipline and morality from the Qur'an. And a kitab like this written by Imam Al-Ajurri rahimahullah will teach us that exactly. We do not want to be from the people who read the Qur'an and its wording merely and we just focus on the wording of the Qur'an. What we want to do is we want to take in the teachings and the lessons that are in the Qur'an, the instructions that the Qur'an is giving us. There are stories that the Qur'an mentions to us that we derive from their benefits. That's why Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He told us in the Qur'an, إِنَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ يَهْدِي لِلَّتِي هِيَ أَقْوَمُ That the Qur'an, it will guide you to the best of affairs. That's what the Qur'an does. It will guide you to the best of affairs. The Qur'an is a book of guidance. And it becomes clear, or it becomes apparent on a person that this guidance comes from this person, and the person becomes guided once they take on the Qur'an. And I say to the people, brothers and sisters, if you want this dunya, learn the Qur'an. And if you want akhirah, learn the Qur'an. And if you want both of them, learn the Qur'an. All of the Islamic knowledge goes back to the Qur'an. He goes back to the Qur'an. So we ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala that He benefits us with whatever is in this book. The good that is in this book, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala benefits us with it and allows us to be from those people who hear these reminders and these lessons and we implement it in our lives. إِنَّهُ وَلِيُّ ذَلِكَ وَالْقَادِرُ عَلَيْهِ I also ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He rewards the author of this book. Al-Imam al-Aajurri rahimahullah for the hard work and the effort that he exerted in writing this book. I also ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bestow His mercy on myself and allow me to be able to finish this book and give it justice. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also that He allows all of you to benefit from this humble explanation of mine inshaAllah ta'ala on the kitab. رَبِّ شَرَحْ لِي صَدْرِي وَيَسِّرْ لِي أَمْرِي وَحْلُ الْعُقُدَةً مِنْ لِسَانِي يَفْقَهُ قَوْلِي Al-Imam al-Aajurri rahimahullah, he started the kitab by saying, أَحَقُّ مَا اسْتُفْتِحَ بِهِ الْكَلَامُ الْحَمْدُ لِمَوْلَانَا الْكَرِيمِ وَأَفْضَلُ الْحَمْدِ مَا حَمِدَ بِهِ الْكَرِيمُ نَفْسَهُ فَنَحْنُ نَحْمَدُهُ بِهِ Al-Imam al-Aajurri started his book by saying, أَحَقُّ مَسْتُفْتِحَ بِهِ الْكَلَامُ The thing, the most rightful way to start a speech is to praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala لِمَوْلَانَا الْكَرِيمُ That we praise our master, the most generous one. The word Alhamdu, it means wasful mahmud. It is to describe the one that you're praising, Subhanah, and this is Allah Subhanahu wa Taala here, bil kamal, that Allah Tabarak wa Taala is complete. Ma'a mahabbati, whilst you're describing Allah Tabarak wa Taala to be complete, you are in love with Him Subhanahu wa Taala, wa ta'zimihi, and you are honoring Him and venerating Him and glorifying Him Subhanahu wa Taala. So it's to praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by saying that Allah is complete. There is nothing incomplete about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's complete in all angles and all affairs subhanahu wa ta'ala. There's no deficiency in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We love Him completely and we are always going to glorify and honor Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. The author, he started his kitab with the hamdalah. He started by saying, Alhamdulillah. And him starting his book with the hamdalah is correct. And it shows that the Shaykh rahimahullah, because his book is going to discuss Qur'an, the etiquette of the person who's carrying the Qur'an, he wants to make his book similar to the Qur'an. And what is that? The Qur'an, it starts with Surah Al-Fatiha, which is Surah that has in it, the beginning of it, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. And of course, this is in accordance to the view that you take regarding the Basmala. Is the Basmala an ayah from Surah Al-Fatiha or not? وَأَفْضَلُ الْحَمْدِ The author says, the greatest form of hamd is مَا حَمِدَ بِهِ الْكَرِيمُ نَفْسَهُ The greatest form of hamd is that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised Himself with. The best hamd is the hamd Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did for Himself. The one that He praised Himself with is the best. فَنَحْنُ نَحْمَدُهُ بِهِ And because of that, we praise Him subhanahu wa ta'ala with that. We praise Him with that. وَلِذَلِكَ The Qur'an, there are five surahs in the Qur'an in which start with the hamdalah. Five surahs. They all start with the hamdalah. The first one is Surah Al-Fatiha. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He started it by saying, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. The second one is Surah Al-An'am. Surah Al-An'am, it starts with the hamdalah. The third one is Surah Al-Kahf. The fourth one is Surah Al-Saba. And the fifth one is Surah Al-Fatir. Surah Al-Fatir is the fifth. Those are the five surah in the Qur'an. All of them start with the hamdalah. Alhamdulillah. So what the author is saying that we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the way He praised Himself. And there's nothing greater than that. That we praise Him in the way He praised Himself subhanahu wa ta'ala. What do we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for? We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for our worldly affairs, but for sure we praise Him number one for this religion He has brought us. For this religion that He has brought us, that is the greatest thing that we praise Him for, subhanahu wa ta'ala. ولذلك it was narrated that Waqi' ibn Jarrah al-Ru'asi, he came to Mecca. Waqi' rahimahullah, he came to Mecca. وَكَانَ سَمِينًا Waqi' was said that he was a chubby person. He was chubby, Waqi' ibn Jarrah al-Ru'asi was chubby. So he came to Mecca. فَقَالَ لَهُ الْفُضَيْلِ بْنُ عِيَاضٍ فُضَيْلِ بْنُ عِيَاضٍ said to him, مَا هَذَا السِّمَنُ What is this chubbiness? Why are you so chubby, Waqi'? وَأَنْتَ رَاهِبُ الْعِرَاقِ And you are the rahib of Iraq. You are the worshipper of Iraq. يعني Waqi' was known to be an aesthetic person and a worshipper. يعني a man who distanced himself from the dunya and his heart is connected to the akhirah. That's the type of person you are, Waqi'. But here you are, you're chubby. يعني he's trying to say you eat. So, فَقَالَ لَهُ وَكِيعَ وَكِيعَ ibn Jarrah al-Ru'asi responded back to Al-Fudayl ibn Iyadin and he said to him, هَذَا مِنْ فَرَحِي بِالْإِسْلَامِ The reason why I'm like this is because of my happiness for Islam. I am so happy that I'm a Muslim. It's not because I eat a lot. The reason I'm like this is because هَذَا مِنْ فَرَحِي بِالْإِسْلَامِ It is my happiness that I am happy with Islam. So we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for Islam. And we are happy that Allah made us Muslims. The author rahimahullah then mentioned, he said, Alhamdu lillahi, praises to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alladhi, the one, anzala ala abdihi, he sent on his slave. Ala abdihi here means Nabiullah Muhammad. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Nabiullah Muhammad is what? Akhirul mursaleen. He's the final and last messenger. وَخَاتَمَ النَّبِيِّينَ And he's the final prophet. What did he send on him? الْكِتَابَ Allah sent on him the book. The kitab here, it means Al-Qur'an. The Qur'an. The Qur'an is what? خَاتَمَ الْكُتُبْ It is the final books which is sent down from Allah. المنزلة. It is the final prophet book that was sent down. Then the final messenger and prophet is Nabi Muhammad. And the final book that was sent down is the Qur'an. Now, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is referring to the prophet as a slave. He's referring to him as a what? Abd. And that is the greatest thing that a person can be referred to. And there is no level higher for a slave than being called a slave. ولذلك Allah used the term abd for the prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam at times of honoring the Prophet. مَوَاضِعَ الْمَدْحِ Places of praise, Allah used the word abd for him. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said, سُبْحَانَ الَّذِي أَسْرَى بِعَبْدِهِ بِعَبْدِهِ The night Allah, he raised the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Prophet was ascended high up. Allah referred to him as what? سُبْحَانَ الَّذِي أَسْرَى بِعَبْدِهِ His slave. When Allah tabarak wa ta'ala was talking about sending the Qur'an on him, He referred to him, Alhamdulillah, الَّذِي أَنْزَلَ عَلَىٰ عَبْدِهِ الْكِتَابَ Sending the Qur'an, which is something great. Allah referred to him as a slave. When it came to the Prophet ﷺ standing up to convey the message of Al-Islam and to convey the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah said, وَلَمَّا قَامَ عَبْدُ اللَّهِ يَدْعُوهُ كَادُوا يَكُونُونَ عَلَيْهِ لِبَدًا Allah referred to him in times and positions of great importance Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala referred to the Prophet as a slave, abd. But what we know is that the Prophet is not an ordinary slave. He's a what? Abdun fala yu'bad. He's a slave, so he's not worshipped. Wa rasulun fala yukaddam. And he's a messenger, he's not disbelieved in. Walakin yuta'u wa yutaba. The Prophet is obeyed and he's followed. He's not a god that we worship him, no. He's a abdi slave. But he's not an ordinary slave. He's a rasul min indillah. He's a messenger from Allah. Even that's the position that we put the Prophet in. We don't fall into ifrat or tafrid. We don't fall into extreme exaggeration, nor do we fall into extreme negligence when it comes to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Alhamdulillah, he praises to who? Alladhi anzala, the one who sent down. Ala abdihi, onto his slave. Al kitab, he sent unto him in the book. Walam yaj'al, and Allah did not make. Walam yaj'al lahu iwaja, and Allah did not make inside that book iwajan, deviance. Allah did not make in this book any deviance, any crookedness. This Quran, it is not deviated. It will not deviate the person. The Quran has ahkam, which are jurisprudential rulings, and it has akhbar. This is what the Quran consists of. Has akhbar, news that it tells you of the previous nations and the prophets, and it also has ahkam, rulings. Okay, some ahkam are ahkam amaliyya and some are ahkam ilmiyya. Ahkam amaliyya are jurisprudential rulings, fiqiyat, halal and haram. And there's ahkam which are ilmiyya. Ahkam ilmiyya which are aqadi related issues. Aqidah related issues. And then the Quran is ahkam and it's also akhbar. There's no crookedness in any of the two. وَتَمَّتْ كَلِمَةُ رَبِّكَ صِدْقًا وَعَدْلًا. The Quran, صِدْقٌ فِي الْأَخْبَارِ وَعَدْلٌ فِي الْأَحْكَامِ. That's why it has no عِوَجٍ in it. The Quran is a book of guidance. It's got no crookedness in it, no deviance in it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قَيِّمًا. The word قَيِّمًا is a accusative condition. يعني in Arabic it's a hal. Hal, halul lil kitab. Allah is describing the kitab for you, giving you an understanding of the kitab. What is it? Qayyiman. That's why it's mansub. Accusative. It's mansub. Qayyiman here means straight. The Quran is straight. Liyundira. The Quran, what does it do? Liyundira. The Quran warns. The word liyundira takes two maf'ul, two objects grammatically. It takes two objects. And the first object here is implicit. It's withheld, it's hidden. So it's what? لِيُنْذِرَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. لِيُنْذِرَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. The Quran came down to warn the disbelievers. وَلِذَلِكَ, the word إِنْذَار in the Arabic language, it means الْإِعْلَانُ مَعَ التَّهْدِيدِ وَالتَّخْوِيفِ. It is to notify someone something whilst there is a threat in it and you're putting in the person fear. Indar, that's what it means. The Quran, it warns. Warning means you tell the person this is wrong whilst you're instilling in the person fear by saying to him, if you don't do it, this is going to happen to you. That's what the word indar means. So the Quran, what does it do to the disbelievers? لِيُنْذِرَ الَّذِينَ. The Quran is a warner. For who? الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. The disbelievers. It's a warner for the disbelievers. إِذَنْ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا is hidden from the ayah. That's what the ayah says. لِيُنْذِرَ بَأْسًا شَدِيدًا. So the Quran is a warner. The second thing that the Quran is that the Quran gives glad tidings. And who does it give glad tidings to? The ones who follow it and implement it and live by it. It gives them glad tidings. That the path that they are on and the road that they have chosen, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to place them in Jannah. لِيُنْذِرَ الَّذِينَ, for the Quran to warn the disbelievers. For what? بَأْسًا شَدِيدًا, a severe punishment. That's what the Quran is warning them for. مِنْ لَدُونْهُ, from him. وَيُبَشِّرَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, and the Quran is giving glad tidings to who? The believers. The believers. Which believers? الَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ الصَّالِحَاتِ, the ones who are doing righteous actions. What does it mean when we hear in the Quran, the ones who are doing righteous actions? Righteous action is when your action is based on sincerity and in accordance to the sunnah. If your action is done with sincerity and is also in accordance to the sunnah, it's a righteous action. And if it lacks any one of those two, then your action is not righteous. What is it that it's promising the believers, or the glad tidings for the believers? أَنَّ لَهُمْ أَجْرًا حَسَنًا, that for them is أَجْرًا حَسَنًا. What does it mean, أَجْرًا حَسَنًا? يَعْنِي الْجَنَّةِ. For them is Jannah. That's what they're going to get. And also, what are they going to get? وَالْفَوْزُ بِرِضْوَانِ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. They're also going to receive, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to be pleased with them. مَاكِثِينَ فِيهِ أَبَدًا means what? خَالِدِينَ فِي هَذَا النَّعِيمِ, that they're going to stay in that reward, they're going to stay in that Jannah, abad al-abad. They'll stay there what? Abad al-abad, forever, and ever, and ever. So this Qur'an is a warner for the disbelievers. And this Qur'an is also a glad tiding for the believers who are coming with the righteous action. And in the glad tiding that it gives them is what? Jannah is your final abode. You guys will enter Jannah. And you'll stay there forever. In this episode, we'll take that much inshaAllah ta'ala. And we'll carry on in our next episode. Bi-idhnillahi al-kareem. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayhi.
Assalamu alaikum. If you're enjoying these videos and you'd like to keep up to date with all of the courses we're going to be running, make sure you head over to amauathome.com.